Hello friends, hello student. Today I will discuss the term second and the lesson which are appeared in the term second, the lesson which I am telling now. Term second lesson. In history, nationalism in India. Second lesson is in geography. Manufacturing industry. Next lesson in geography. Lifelines of national economy. Then this is history. This is geography. Then this is economics. Okay na? So first lesson in economics, money and credit. And next lesson is globalization and Indian economy. And last book is civics, where the two lessons are there, political parties. The next lesson is outcomes of democracy. So student, that is very important things in the seventh lesson, where the strategy which has been decided by the board in the conditions when the pandemic will be come back again. So in such a way, the schedules and declaration was made by the CBSE will be followed. Otherwise, if any kind of the disease cannot be appeared in the time of board exam, then the as usual schedule will be followed. So there is the two method for study of the seven lesson. One is MCQs based questions, and second is small and long question answer. So these are the two method, okay na, which has to be applied while you are just preparing the exam, because anyone cannot say that the problem can be bigger or smaller, but we have to made our two method for study well in SST. So according to me, or which I have considered about the strategy for the, you'll say preparing for the exam, so which I have decided now, I'm telling here. Nationalism in India, that is very scoring lesson, and this is very important for the question answer and map based, okay na? And the second part of the second book, that is very important for the question answer and the map also. So these two books which are very important, because in this book the maps can be asked, and these two sections of the SST, where the economics and the civics can be you will say put into the exam, where no any map will be appeared in the exam. So the two books which are very very important, one is history and second is geography, you know. And what is the planning, how do we study, how, what is the we'll say procedure, what is the kind of a strategy, what is the method to study all these subject, all these books. So number one is all the student which I am telling here, that they have to read the whole lesson number one of the each book, number one thing, that is the strategy, you know, that is the strategy which I am telling here. Now second is, after reading the whole books, you have to just go through the lesson while you are just completed the reading section. So you have to make underline, make under lines of every important term only. Okay, na? This is the second strategy, that is the second method that will be helpful for you. That is, you have to, while you are just reading section completed, so after reading section, or while you are reading, then you can do also the same time. Okay, na? Let's make underline the every important term which you have seen in the lesson. Do not leave any term. That is the second strategy. And then next one, that when you completed the reading section and making the underline the term which are very important, after this you have to listen very carefully. You have to, number one, that you have to note down okay, na? All the terms in the one area only, but you have to write them under the section in which section you are writing it: history, geography, economics, civics. Okay, na? So every term must be written by you, and where there is not any sentences, only the term must be written there. Then after writing the term, note down every term, okay, na? Then you have to make clear the meaning of the term. That is a very important strategy, because the term which you are writing, the meaning of the term have, that every term have a meaning. So either you have to take the meaning of the term in the book inside, or you will take the help of the dictionary, or if any kind of that term which is very difficult for you, you can ask to me. I will clear it. Okay, na? So that is the very important strategy. Next one, because this is the strategy for preparing the exam, if the MCQ based paper will be appeared. And then next strategy, that you have to read the individual, you will say, portion of the lesson where you have to clear the every important topics. And topics you will just search out from your books, or you can also take the help of your teacher, or you can also ask to me which topics which are very important in the lesson. Suppose you are studying history, this is in India, and how many topics which are very important. So a simple ordinary student can tell, sir, every topic is very important, as I have seen the books, as I have seen the lesson, every portion of the lesson is very, very simple. Very, very known. So every topic is very, very important by the student. But according to me, every portion in the books, in the lesson, that is not very important. Which portion of the book is very important? So number one thing, what you have to search, which portion of the book is very, very important. So you have to find out if the date, term, people name, person name means, okay, na? Or any kind of the fact has been given much in the paragraph. It means that paragraph is very, very important. Very, very important paragraph you have to find out. And that paragraph must be prepared by you. And how do you prepare this paragraph? You have to prepare this paragraph in the two way. Number one is, you have to make the small questions answers. Clear? The second thing, after getting All these features in the paragraph has been found by you. After making the small question answer, then you will do one or two. Listen it very carefully. One or two long answer you have to prepare from the same paragraph. Long question answer. And what is the method of making the question answer that I am telling now? Listen it and watch it very carefully. How do you prepare this question answer? Okay, na? So what you have to do when there is a paragraph. So in the paragraph, when you have found out everything, date, person name, fact, date, everything is there. If you have found there, so you have to write the answer. If it is a long answer, small answer can be written only to the 2 points. Small question answer must be written with 2. Okay, na? 2, you will say sentences. 2 sentences. Clear, student? If it is a long answer, then you have to write the answer in such a way which I am telling now. There are 3 part of the long answer. Number 1 is introduction. Clear, everyone? Then second thing is that main body, the main part of the answer where the important thing can be seen there. Reason, factor, clear, causes must be written in the main part. Then after one, conclusion. This is the first part, second part, third part. Conclusion, what you have to write there? You have to introduce. Introduce means present the answer. Present the answer. It means you have to give the context. You have to give the reference. What do you want to tell about the answer? Means what do you want to tell about the answer? What is the references? What is the context which you want to deliver in the answer? The context, the references will help to understand the teacher who is just going to check your sheet. Okay, na? Then after writing main part, where the region, factors, causes or any kind of the other things can be there, so you have to write in the main part. The answer will not be written in such a way that you will write the one number, two number, second number, third number. No, this is not the way. You have to write the one small paragraph for the introduction. Then second paragraph will write about the region, factor or causes. So you have to write the second paragraph, but do not write the numbers of the paragraph. And third one, conclusion, you have to write the references. This is not the references where you are concluding your answer. Your concluding answer means you want to give the message. What have you written there in the answer? Okay, na? What have you written in the answer? The answer which can be reflected in your conclusion means you are just going to cover your whole part of the answer in the conclusion. Means you want to you are going to give the message that I am just going to finish. Okay, na? So you want to deliver there that you want to deliver a message in the conclusion. Okay, na? यहाँ पर आपको एक मैसेज देना है पूरे आंसर को लेकर, कि मतलब आप यहाँ पर क्या कहना चाह रहे हैं, क्या कहना चाहते हैं, जिससे क्या होगा कि जो आंसर चेक करने वाला होगा तो उसको एक एक मतलब एक रीजन मिलेगा आपको आंसर को चेक करने का, अदरवाइज कोई भी एक बच्चे आते हैं और आंसर लिख के चले जाते हैं। फिर दूसरी जो बात है, इसके अलावा इस स्ट्रेटेजी के अलावा राइटिंग, राइटिंग सेक्शन जो है बच्चों का बहुत कमज़ोर होता है। तो राइटिंग हर बच्चे की एक जैसी नहीं होती है, हर बच्चे की डिफरेंट राइटिंग होती है, बहुत ज़्यादा वर्सटाइल राइटिंग होती है हर बच्चे की। तो यहाँ पर मैं केवल एक मैसेज देना चाहूँगा कि यदि आपकी राइटिंग बहुत ज़्यादा ख़राब है तो आप इस तरीके से लिख सकते हैं जैसे मैंने यहाँ पर लिखा हुआ है, ठीक है ना। यदि आपकी राइटिंग बहुत अच्छी है तो आप उसको कर्सिव लिख सकते हैं। लेकिन अब यहाँ पर बात आती है कि राइटिंग जो है बहुत अच्छे बच्चे की कभी कभी बहुत ज़्यादा डल लगती है और कभी बहुत पुअर राइटिंग बहुत कभी कभी अच्छी लगती है। तो यहाँ पर किसका रोल होता है? पेन का। तो हमें एक पेन बहुत ही अच्छा लेना चाहिए। पेन कैसा लेना चाहिए? जो बहुत ज़्यादा मतलब ब्राइट तो ना हो बट हाँ बहुत ज़्यादा इम्प्रिंट कर रहा हो एक तरीके से, उसके लेटर जो है वो अलग से ही पता चल जाए, ठीक है ना। तो डल पेन हमें यूज़ बिल्कुल नहीं करना, क्योंकि डल पेन जो है वो डल राइटिंग को ही आगे क्या करेगा, डिलीवर करेगा, आगे बढ़ाएगा, ठीक है ना स्टूडेंट। सो यू हैव टू मेक श्योर इन योर माइंड दैट यू विल फॉलो द स्ट्रेटेजी विच आई एम टेलिंग हियर, एंड फ्रॉम टुमारो आई विल डिस्कस एवरी लेसन वन बाई वन, एंड आई विल टेल यू द स्ट्रेटेजी, द क्वेश्चन आंसर, वाट इज द मेथड which you have to apply. I have told you and I will go according to this method, and the question answer, the MCQs, all the portion of the paragraph I will discuss along with you, okay na student, from tomorrow. So this method will help you to watch to prepare in the exam for securing the good marks. So thank you student to listen me and watching me.